evidence of our virtuality. Grand Theft Auto 5, also known as GTA 5, is a very good example of how all this could be accomplished. In the game, on one of the many streets of its virtual city called Los Santos, you see a very familiar picture. You are surrounded by cars that are hurrying to and fro somewhere into the distance, and crowds of people line the sidewalks. In general, everything's very similar to how it is in real life. And in the game, this general picture accompanies you everywhere, all the time, regardless of your location in Los Santos. If you turn a corner, you see more cars and more crowds of passersby. So, being on that Los Santos street, you might think that the same story is happening to others, that life is alive and happening in the whole city at any point in the urban landscape. But, in fact, this is simply not true. You must not forget that everything you see is just an illusion, built just for you. While you are on the street with the conditional name A, absolute nothingness has filled street B. Nothing happens there. The game continuously, magically draws for you this living, active life, while street B drowns in silence and, in fact, barely exists. All modern video games work on this principle. When you are absent from a certain location of a virtual city, there is absolutely nothing at this location. No people, no cars, no city itself. The developers optimize the game in order to reduce the load on the computer hardware. Thanks to this, you can enjoy such incredibly realistic graphics and in-game physics that are the modern masterpieces of the gaming industry. If a player, or rather a character, turns and looks at something, the computer makes the image in front of him as detailed as possible, and the textures and objects behind the player's back, that is, out of view, become as simple as computationally possible, or really disappear altogether, except as a potentiality. As we said, this allows the computer to reduce the load on the game platform while maintaining beautiful graphics. If you look at the location from on high in GTA 5, the whole city will look as if it is in the palm of your hand, and you will see how cars are rushing up and down all of the numerous streets. So, does that mean the power of a console or a computer is enough for such a complex and detailed picture? Let's not jump to conclusions. The fact is that the physics of the game also get simplified for objects like cars that are far from the observer. If we fire a rocket into such distances, we can barely see it explode. If we fly closer, then the explosion looks much more detailed and realistic, and requires far more computer power. The next example is the game Civilization 5. If you quickly move the camera from one end of the map to the other, you will see the location loaded right before your eyes. The game engine is not perfect, so we can see how the view responds to our actions, realizing that we are looking at it. That is, the observer influences the game world by the very fact of his or her observation. This is how any video games of the future will work as well. Even if super powerful computers can simultaneously calculate all the more or less large objects in a large location, even over many years, small details will remain to be rendered. Flies, blades of grass, and yes, even microbes, of which there are quite a few. All of which will be loaded only under the gaze of the observer player. Everything is for the sake of optimization. So, after that gaming preface, we now move on to the first proof of the theory that we are living in a matrix-like simulation. You may know about or remember one of the most famous experiments in the history of physics, the experiment of Thomas Young, the double slit experiment. It was a real coup in physics and led many scientists into the study of quantum mechanics. If you throw solid balls at a shield with a slit cut into it, a single diffuse strip designating the strike points will appear on the screen behind the shield. If there are two slits in the shield, then there will be two strips. But how will waves behave if aimed at the shield? They will pass through the slot and spread out. The greatest impact of the waves will be in the line of the slit, as in the case with the balls. But if you add a second slit, everything changes. A number of alternating interference strips will appear on the projection screen. And when we shine light on the two strips, this is exactly what happens. And this is how Mr. Young proved the wave theory of light. If light were corpuscular, like a particle, instead of wave-like, It would behave like the balls, and the screen would show two strips of light corresponding to the two slits. That didn't happen. Later, it turned out that electrons and protons behave exactly the same way, showing that they also seem to exist as waves and not as points. There was one assumption that perhaps light and the others were particles and that somehow the particles bumped into each other and flew apart. So, to test this, physicists decided to shoot electrons at the target one by one, single file. And what do you think happened? The strangest thing imaginable. The interference pattern still appeared on the screen. It seemed that the single electrons somehow divided into two waves, passed through both slits, then interfered with themselves. Impossible. So physicists tried to find out through which gap the electron actually passes. They installed measuring instruments to check this. Another seeming impossibility occurred. The electrons stopped behaving like waves and began acting like particles, and left a trace on the screen of two distinct strips, with no interference. They had to admit something completely mind-blowing, that the fact of our observation or measurement destroyed the wave function of the photons, causing them to become like points, corpuscular. The electron, under the influence of observation, behaved like a particle, flying through one slit and not through two. Interpretations. Well, it certainly looks like the work of a game engine, doesn't it? This might make you think that our world is running like a game on a computer. The computer's power is not enough to calculate the motion of each and every particle, so it uses a simplified model and applies precise calculations only if an observer needs to look at the particle, so as not to break the illusion of the reality of the world for the observer. Such an explanation could not have occurred to people from the past. The results of Thomas Young's experiment were published in 1803, when it was impossible to even think about virtual reality. There were many theories suggested for just what the heck was going on. If we substitute a virtual reality in place of the physical world, the instant connection is easily explained. When two photons become entangled, their programs are combined to jointly see the two points. This combination of programs will respond for both pixels, if we can call them that, no matter where they are. At the moment of measuring one particle, its program randomly chooses one of the spins, and the program of the second immediately reacts. It becomes clear why the distance isn't important. The processor does not need to go to the pixel to ask it to spin, even if the so-called screen is large, even as large as a universe. Physicists say that no one really understands quantum mechanics, but if we assume that our world is virtual, everything quickly becomes quite clear. To describe the world of elementary particles and their interaction, scientists use quantum mechanics, and for the macro world, Einstein's general theory of relativity is used. But if these two worlds coexist in nature, then a theory must exist that would allow for both. And this is exactly what the hypothesis of simulation does. It perfectly explains this. The mysteries of the Big Bang, the curvature of space, the tunnel effect, dark energy, and dark matter all can be explained on the basis of the assumption. They say this simulation theory, even if confirmed, wouldn't change anything. But official confirmation could strongly spur new research, and perhaps scientists would be able to find new shortcomings in our world, and they could be used to create new technologies. For example, if quantum effects are caused by the virtuality of the universe, the creation of quantum computers or quantum cryptography can be called the use of the conventions of our world. Are we in a matrix? New, indirect hints that we live in a matrix are discovered every year. At such a rate, in about 30 years, the virtuality theory of our world could become as official in the world of science as the theory of evolution today. Perhaps it won't be too long until they teach in schools that we live in a virtual world. Although it is somewhat demotivating, realizing that you might be just a complicated program with feelings and self-consciousness. Elon Musk believes that, on the contrary, it would be good news. The simulation hypothesis solves the Fermi paradox and shows that intelligent civilizations are able to avoid self-destruction and technologically grow to achieve even the creation of virtual worlds. So, life in the Matrix for Mr. Musk is a pretty decent utopia. He wants this to be true. By the way, recently the famous scientist Neil deGrasse Tyson and some of his colleagues spent several hours debating the topic, is the universe a computer simulation? Be sure to watch it. If you like this topic, I advise you to see the film The 13th Floor and, of course, the Matrix trilogy. And don't forget to put likes and subscribe to the channel. Otherwise, Agent Smith will come knocking on your door very soon.